In July of 1994, you and Carolyn, Bob and Viola and Rick Joyner were at our home, and on the same morning, every one of us woke up with a revelation that God was going to do something in Pensacola.
That's right.
Why don't you just share that portion of that for yourself?
Yeah, the Lord began to say He was going to ring a bell, He was going to send a light, and He was going to have a real move in Pensacola, in that region. And we had it. Bob Jones had it. You had it. We even took a journey. Remember, we drove around looking for the spot. And I tell you what, God did that, didn't He?
He did. And if you'll remember, we went right back to your church right after that.
Yeah.
And part of the word was that God was going to release repentance,
yes,
leading to righteousness, leading to power,
yeah,
evangelism.
That's true.
That was actually prophesied,
yeah,
right from your church about the Brownsville outpouring.
Yeah.
About the Pensacola. We didn't,
yeah,
know Brownsville. We didn't know it was going to be Brownsville. We didn't. All we knew was Pensacola. And sure enough, I think it could have been a lot more than it,
yeah,
was. But
that was the theme of it, wasn't
that
it?
That was the theme.
That was the track it ran on.
Yeah, it was an awakening. Some people believe that it fulfilled a prophecy from William Branham when he said in 1955 that the revival was ending, and it would be 40 years before the Holy Spirit really came back with power. And that may or may not be true, but it may be something to that. But who knows?
Why don't you tell that deal if you don't mind? When we were there at the lodge, and we'd been, Bob said there's three other guys that's supposed to be here. Remember?
Yeah, two. Yeah,
two other guys.
Two other guys. I will. This was January of actually started in the fall of 1995. Bobby was a witness to all this. But in the fall of 1995, Bob Jones calls me up. And he said, I just had a revelation, and I saw the date, January 16th, but he said, I had no idea what it means. I said, I know exactly what it means. January 16th was the date that William Branham stood up in 1956 and said that revival was over. America had turned down her opportunity. And so we knew that the next January 16th would have been 40 years to the date. So he calls up Rick. Rick Joyner sets up a meeting in Raven Falls, an invitation-only meeting. On January 10th, 1996, I get another phone call from Bob. He said, I just had another vision. He calls it the teller line vision.
Mm.
It's like the Lord was standing behind a bank counter cashing checks, that we were going to cash checks on heaven. And he said, I saw two men in this vision. He saw three men, and I was one of them, but he saw two other men. And he said, these men are supposed to go to the meeting in Raven Falls. So Rick says, who are they? He said, I don't know. He said, where are they from? I don't know. He said, they just got to be in the meeting. So January 16th, 1996, we're meeting in Raven Falls at Harry and Louise Bazell's Lodge. And Bob kept saying all morning, we can't start the meeting until these two men show up. And Rick says, everybody's here that's invited. Nobody else is coming. He said, well, two men are going to come. We break for lunch. Nothing had happened. We come back after lunch, and I'm sharing the story, just like I am now, about why we're there. Why we're there on January 16th, 1996, 40 years to the day, and about that time the door opens and two men walk in. Bob says, there they are. And so these two men had been on a missionary journey, driving up from Florida to New York, visiting churches, were turned around on the way back, and just on a whim decided to stop by Moravian Falls to see who was there, and they walked right into our meeting. So they sit down, and I begin to share the story again. And about halfway through, I said, in 1956, William Branham said America turned down our opportunity. One of the men raised his hand, a 77-year-old man by the name of Ray Kirschke, and he said, I was in that meeting. We were stunned. We were stunned. This man was in the meeting in 56, and God had him in our little lodge up in Moravian Falls, North Carolina, on the anniversary, 40th anniversary. And so we felt like it was significant.
Tell them a little bit about what Brother Kirschke said. Here's what he said. He said, I was in that meeting. He said, the day before that meeting, we were emptying whole hospital wings.
Yep.
That's what he said. After the word came out of Brother Branham's mouth that the American turned down their thing, said that all the power left, they couldn't do anything. But that's pretty
amazing.
You
the
could
man said
orchestrate
he had been,
it.
John G. Lake's,
yeah,
last disciple.
That's the last disciple.
He was mentored by John G. Lake for 18 months. It was a pretty amazing fulfillment. Pretty amazing fulfillment. It makes me believe we're going to pick back up where that revival left off.
Yeah.